All right. Lexington Comic Con. I'm here with Adam Mia. How you doing?
Good, good.
All right, good to see you again. Now, what is it about Lexington Comic Con that keeps you coming back? Because you're here like every year. You interact with the fans and everyone else here. What keeps you coming back?
Honestly, like, people here aren't fans anymore. They're family. Like, this is what, my fourth or fifth year here, and I love it. Every time I come back, everyone's so friendly. The cosplays here are amazing, and it's just the attitude and the spirit of everyone here. I don't know what it is about Lexington. You guys have so much heart, and I love it. So I want to keep coming back here forever.
Well, this year's, they've expanded a lot. I mean, we have the whole Rupp Arena now. Mm-hmm. Who are you looking most forward to seeing this year?
Oh, my gosh. Well, I mean, I know a lot of the Power Rangers, so they're always my favorites to see every year. And then, I mean, there's Kevin Sorbo and a bunch of the other actors. Oh, God, I don't know. There's so many. The girl that plays Catwoman, I want to meet her on Gotham. I think she's really cute, and she's such a good little actress. So, yeah, those are my, like, big things I'm looking forward to. And other than that, just seeing all the costumes and the costume contest tomorrow.
What projects or is there anything you have in the works that you want to tell us you got brewing right now?
Let's see. I've got a Dark Lily from Legend that I'm just putting the finishing touches on. And then I'm doing something from Descendants. It's one of the minor characters, but I kind of love that movie. It's a Disney movie for kids, but I love it. And so I want to put it together. So those are my two big projects next. And then some stuff from Game of Thrones, since I'm going to be going to England this year, and I want to go shoot some Game of Thrones stuff out there. So I'm like, all right, I got to do a Daenerys and maybe a Marjorie Tyrell.
That'd be awesome. Now, for people who want to find you or get in contact with you, tell us where they can find you.
Yeah, I'm on Instagram, Twitter, under Animea Cosplay, or Animea Official. And then on Facebook, I am animea.cosplay.
All right, I'm here with my man Donovan with Dimension X Comics. Well, it's been a lot of, like, different superhero movies. Like, Thor Ragnarok came out a while ago. It's actually about to be on DVD, and Black Panther just dropped. What's been really popular in you guys' store right now?
Exactly what you said. Thor Ragnarok, Black Panther, a little bit of Justice League, a little bit of Wonder Woman, actually, has been really popular. Wonder Woman, a lot of the classic, just everything Marvel, really, has been pretty popular in our store, so yeah.
All right, well, we're working in a comic shop. Like, obviously, you got to be a fan of a lot of stuff, but what really gets your mojo rolling in the comic book world? What do you like?
I got a couple of ideas. I haven't seen a lot of Blue Marvel stuff, but I'm a really big fan of Blue Marvel. You know, he's a cool guy. Sentry, too. If I see something Sentry related, like maybe his, like, first issue, I would definitely, like, be like, I got to get that. You know, I see that. Really gets my gears going.
All right, and I believe you guys have been around since, like, what, 2008?
Yeah.
All right, well, how can, like, people who are in your area, like, find you guys and get in contact with you on social media?
Okay, so we have a Facebook page. We're trying to build a new website now. Once that's up, it'll be on our Facebook. We're based out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. So, you know, talking to my boss, you can just get all the information down. He might have some business cards, anything.
All right, I'm standing here with wrestling legend Jim Cornette, the Louisville Slugger himself. Oh, yeah. Welcome back to Lexington Comic Con.
Thank you. Just say LexCon, because LexCon is known the world over. It's world famous around the globe. LexCon, the standard in comic and pop culture conventions, toys, games, superstars. What more could you ask from one con?
Now, as someone who's been in the wrestling business a while, give us your opinion on the state of the business right now, especially, you know, with WrestleMania.
Can I use that kind of language on this programming?
You sure can.
No, the state of the business is pretty dismal. No, in all honesty, unfortunately, wrestling has let all the tricks out of its bag and let all the magic out of it. And with the influx of corporate broadcasting companies and corporate involvement and publicly traded companies and stock selling and everything, we've kind of missed the essence of what wrestling was. That's getting a guy that the people kind of like and a guy that the people kind of hate and putting them into a collision course to fight each other and see what's going to happen. And now it's all about the ratings and the quarter hours and the merchandise and the sales and et cetera, and we've lost a little of the passion and the emotion. And I think the way we could get back to true pro wrestling greatness is just to tell all the guys on the entire roster that there's only going to be one paycheck given out that week, and it's going to be taped to that door at the end of the room, and let them all try to get it. Now that would bring passion and emotion back to pro wrestling.
Yeah, but with that said, you talk about a lot of this stuff on your podcast.
Yes, I do. The Jim Cornette Experience.
Tell them how they can find it, man.
Google me. No, you can go to jimcornette.com and find anything, because there's a button for the podcast. There's a button for the YouTube channel. There's a button for the collectibles and merchandise. There's a button to read all the great things about professional wrestling I've written. There's a button for everything. At jimcornette.com. So it's a one-stop shop, and then you can listen to my podcast where I do cult casts. Because the Cult of Cornette followers, they want knowledge disseminated to them on a regular basis. And so I inseminate everything I can relating to knowledge that the Cult of Cornette followers want to know on both the Jim Cornette Experience on Thursdays and Corny's Drive-Thru, where I answer their burning questions. Yeah, that's every Monday. And by the way, your questions wouldn't be burning if you wouldn't act that way with those type of people.
Now, is there any other projects or upcoming things we should know about that you're getting involved with?
Yes. As a matter of fact, not only am I expanding the podcast and the YouTube channel, but also I can't discuss the corporate name yet, but one of the major comic book companies, we're talking about doing a graphic novel documenting some of our true pro wrestling stories. And I'm working on a book on the infamous Smoky Mountain Wrestling that everybody wants me to finish. They've been bugging me for decades to do this book, so I'm working on that. And a variety of other, a couple of video shoots this summer. Trying to stay busy without actually leaving the house very often. It's a balancing act.
That's the balance of life.
Actually, yeah. I don't think I'm going to draw another big crowd until my funeral. My funeral will be sold out, because you know what they say. Give the people what they want to see, they will come out for it.
I'm here with Orson of Captured Prey. It's basically a home for the most exclusive transforming figures that you can find. So tell us about Captured Prey and how you got started.
Honestly, got started when I was working at Toys R Us, picking up extra stuff, reselling it to other people. Ended up, I'm like, I need to think a name for this. And had a fan character back in the day, because I was, 18. Everybody does, right? And it was, Tarantula's kind of inspired. So the idea kind of grew out of that. And, of course, the metaphor everybody talks about, hunting for their figures.
Yeah, and you mentioned the Tarantula's concept, because that was the episode he captured Cheetor and Rat Trap had to save him. Like, you Transformers guys know what that's about.
Exactly.
All right, now you mentioned you worked at Toys R Us, but there's a lot going on in the toy industry right now with, Bandai not doing the Power Ranger stuff anymore, the troubles with Toys R Us. What is your opinion on the state of the toy world right now?
Overall, I think things are pretty good. I'm kind of waiting to see what this Toys R Us thing does, because they are, a good chunk of the market, good chunk of Hasbro sales, good chunk of Mattel sales, so that's going to make a dent in their income for sure. They owe them a lot of money. As far as retail, though, nobody really thinks of them first anymore, just because they've lost that spot,
Yeah, it's all online now.
Yeah, it's all online. They've kind of moved away from that. They tried to focus on clothing and baby stuff, and, so I'm not sure how much that's going to affect the market, but things in general are pretty good. This is, it's a good time to be a collector, especially if you grew up in the 80s.
And you guys are basically the home for collectors, especially like myself. Now, you guys have a lot of, exclusive and the third-party stuff is amazing at Capture Prey. And what is some of the most exclusive and rare items that you guys have sold or even carried in your store?
I've had things, Black Fire Convoy, the Lucky Draws, the Galvalio Convoy I've had through. Lately had, a good bit of the Japanese G1 stuff coming through. As far as the exclusivity, that's really got to be a couple of Lucky Draws here and there other than those, but Japanese G1 is the most common thing, I'd say.
Well, you guys have been going strong for quite some time. What's next for Capture Prey?
Man, we're looking at TF Expo later this year, but we'd like to get more, like get more exposure. I mean, word of mouth is the best thing to help us grow. And, you know, the more we can do that, the more we can bring in and the more things we can provide, get everybody's needs fully met, which is what I'd like to do. I'd like to eventually be able to expand into other lines, hit up stuff like Figure Arts, stuff like, I mean, any of the, you know, any of the collector-oriented stuff, particularly robot-focused, but that's my personal taste, you know. Star Wars would be cool, you know. Like to get into more.
Well, that's awesome. Now, for anyone looking for Capture Prey online or any of your social media contact information, shoot it right at the camera for them.
All right. You can find us at CapturedPrey.com. You can also check us out on Facebook at Facebook.com/CapturedPrey or Twitter.com/CapturedPrey if you want to get the latest posts when we get new items in or get pre-orders up.
I'd like to thank you all for tuning in to this edition of On Screen with D. Harris, as well as all of my guests from the 2018 Lexington Comic Con. Keep it locked to the D. Harris brand on Facebook and on YouTube for more episodes of On Screen, including the next episode, which will be coming from the 2018 Piston Powered Autorama in Cleveland, Ohio. Be sure to like and subscribe, as well as check out Team Prodigy 216 on Facebook. I've been D. Harris. Thanks again for watching.